Mother's maiden name was Garibaldi, or Garibaldi, as you should say it, with a little twirl on the R, which I don't do very well. And people who study their history know that Giuseppe Garibaldi was the uniter of Italy. He, with a lot of help from two other people, was famous for uniting Italy in 1860. He was the one that conquered Sicily and the lower part of Italy and brought it together for the King of Piedmont. Garibaldi turned over what he had to the King of Italy, and Italy became a country then. The King of Italy offered my great-grandfather all sorts of honors and become a prince, and his sons to get important positions and so forth. And he turned it all down. My great-grandfather thought that kings were not democratic enough in the small d sense of it. He believed in a republic very strongly, and that's what he wanted, but he was enough of a practical man to see that that wasn't a practical course for Italy at the time. Subsequently, Italy's become a republic, and he would have been very happy about that. He went off to the island of Caprera after that with a sack of beans. That was his reward. It started in 1994 when I was appointed chairman of the board of the Virginia Outdoors Foundation, and it was kind of like a businessman would, you know, what is this all about? Where do I start, type of thing. And so one of the places I started is right here at Aldi Mill. The way I got started at it was it was a problem for me. I had to solve a problem, and the problem was where to get the money to put it together. It was not until all that started to happen, until I saw the mill start to develop as you see it today, with the machinery working and so forth, that I began to really appreciate what all that meant. The mill is really a very significant place to this region. It had to do with farming, it had to do with industry. Mr. Mercer knew what he was doing. He put it in such a crucial place on this highway right here, and the whole farming industry came more or less to center around this, and then to transport their goods east to Alexandria and for big trade and so on and so forth. I mean, that goes beyond or is somewhat different thing than preservation, but it was fun to understand the economics of it, the cultural aspects of it. Hunted with three hunts, the one in Upperville, the one in Middleburg, and then Rappahannock. But with those two right in the local area, I can't say I rode every inch of it. I don't think that's probably correct, but I rode almost all of it. Just imagine somebody now who's sort of sucked up all this knowledge and background and lore of Jeb Stuart and George Custer and so forth, who was a captain coming through here at the time, and many, many others, John Buford and other famous people. And you're sitting on a horse riding in the same territory that they are. And a large part of this, not all, but a large part of it is untouched. It looks the same. It's a dirt road. It's a stone wall. A hedgerow. I mean, it's quite amazing. It's awe-inspiring, or as the young people say it's awesome. Welburn is a piece of property about 400 acres. It's located more or less between Middleburg and Upperville to the north, probably closer to Upperville. Welburn is an old property, historic house, wonderful story of owners and what they did in the Civil War. Not only the Civil War, but his family and so forth, subsequently being one of the leaders of the area right up to this day. But they found themselves in a position that a lot of people with land did, lots of land and not enough money. And they had this beautiful piece of property right in the heart of so many things, of fox hunting country. How do you protect that? What do you do? So luckily, by that time, we had enough connections, BOF did, and I did in particular down in Richmond, that we got the money. We paid for the easement. That was one of the early ones. And it amounted to, well, I probably shouldn't say the amount, but it was a substantial amount of money. And it helped the owners to fix up some of the property. A wonderful old barn, for instance, on the main house. And to help improve the property, so survival and so forth. And what Virginia, the Commonwealth, ended up with is just an absolute jewel of a property, under easement, under protection now from development. And I'd say that's the crown jewel of my time and in Virginia Outdoors Foundation. I think it probably is still today.
What's your advice to people who want to follow in your footsteps?
There's nothing in college that you're going to learn that teaches you how to do this. It's not entirely a lawyer's job. It's a concept. It's a rationale. It's something new you need to put together, and that comes up here between the ears and in the heart.